starting in the most, like, copyrightable level by Disney. About to get this nuked from orbit. What is the thing? Hello, everyone. We're gonna finish this today. Swan to John, as it says in the stream title. It might not say that on YouTube. Also, so as we're getting started, thank you online C BF LW. I don't know what those levels, that combination of letters mean. Dude. I love the square. Oh shit. I love the square trees. Hi, Vegenta. I saw you got upset that you're ordering food for some reason. I'm like, hey guys, don't even worry about it. I'm like, hello, Crystal Rivers. Don't even worry about it. I love you, Vegenta. Don't even worry about it. I'm like awake. Hey, Limo. I wasn't like just sleeping, like literally just sleeping. And woke up and realized I need to start streaming because Pig Vegeta Chen and I had an argument in Discord the other day that I don't really have a schedule. I'm just kind of fucking lazy and do whatever. Rush Gallery has both happy and sad orcs. Pairing all of one type can really change the characters of the hall. So yeah, this is where Oswald used to hang out. It isn't that. It used to be. Listen. In case anyone's wondering, it used to be Sunday, Saturday, and then like an extra day. Now it's Tuesday, Wednesday, because I have work. So, also there's a slobber. But yeah, so this used to be, you can look below, first off, I know I'm bad at streaming. I have been like sticking to that much at least for the past, I would say, week or two. Like, definitely for a minute now. I'm not so bad that I've missed entire days. I know that for a fact. But second off, I assumed I broadcasted that much at least. There's a lot of boys. This is a small hall, and there's a lot of boys. Also, there's really cool concept art of this area, with Mickey facing a slobber. I should do fan art of Epic Mickey when this is all done. Oh, hey, look, a golden pin. I didn't even know that was there. Thanks, Vegeta. You're a great, encouraging friend. I'm joking, you're the reason I have most of my subscribers. It hurts my feelings that because I don't blame you, I blame myself for not broadcasting it more clearly. Also, apparently he can't hit him, so, oh. Let me hit him away. Okay, open up your mouth, big boy. Big boy, open up your mouth. Come on. It's time for your goo. There we go. Sub, but well, here's the thing, right? The people who are sub to me are followers, so therefore that it makes sense that any subs I get are from you. Well, also, I'm just gonna repair every painting because fucking I love the paint. I love the art in it. This was a room where they were like, we're just gonna show off the art we made. Yes, we faced a few of those. At Oswald. Oswald's somewhere around here. But yeah, so this used to be where Oswald and Hortensia hung out before, you know, I killed everyone. But I'm just gonna repair the paintings. I digress. Let's just have some fun. We're just having some fun here. If Oswald was here right now. And listen, I have done my best. I don't know what this does. I'll leave this for now, because this might be the thinner option. I don't want to go... Listen, the castle's going to get a little wrecked as we manage to finish the game up, but I don't want it to get that wrecked. Oh. Ooh, a sketch. I heard some kind of evil whispering. Oh! Yeah, so the blot's just kind of around here. He's just kind of like in the castle. So we're gonna find. I do remember that. I do remember that this part of the game gets progressively more tentacly as you go through it. Oh no. This is before Indiana Jones got bought by Disney. For the record. Okay. There's just the one boulder. We're good. More concept art. You vibing. You didn't finish the beak painting. That's the last painting. Also. I did make a promise that, what is it? We are going to go through the concept art I've managed to get. I was trying to get all of it, but then I realized I'd really have to grind to get all of it. So I kind of chickened out, but we're going to play. Listen, if this channel goes on for any more amount of time, we will return to this game at one part. And on subsequent playthroughs, we are going to get to 100%. So don't even worry about it. You cannot get to 100% on a single playthrough. So. Give me a second. But yeah, so. That's Cahill's excuse. I literally like how there's some paintings where it's just like, this was just made to make you feel sad. And Gus even said as much. It's just like, there's just sad paintings. We just made some. Also, I realize I probably didn't get all the gremlins.
Look, there's an activation crystal. When hit with an energy beam, those come through hidden machinery or device.
I mean, listen. Listen, hey, Gus, listen. I don't have a lot of knowledge. I know an activation crystal when I see one. Give him a try. Okay, I want us to use our spin move. Also, yeah, the Mad Doctor used to be way friendlier. Also, look at this really happy. Spin move. Wait, spin move? Oh.
Lovely, isn't it? Well, it is. If you spin gargoyles around, the beam will bounce off each other.
Okay. Whatever you say. This is a puzzle. I didn't even know there were small paintings. At this point, it stops being a kid's game because it's the last level, and they're just like, these are fucking puzzles. Magenta, do you have a bot that says when I'm streaming, or do you do that manually? Also, I love how you can just hear the big guy stomping around downstairs. He's not dead, so he just kind of chills. Also, the castle... So here's the thing. The castle is one of the areas that comes back in the second game. And it keeps a lot of cool gothic art, like the courtyard. You don't see as much of it, but it's still cool. Wow, so you just ignore Chen? Okay. And they say I don't acknowledge Chen's existence. Which one is this? Fantasia. Hey, this is one of my favorite movies. Chen has his own Discord. Uh-huh.
copyrightable music again. Hey, Juice! It's today. Juice, it's today. We're gonna try and finish Epic Mickey. Or my name isn't. Anyway. If you haven't seen Fantasia, you should go give it a watch. Ralph Cahill would be happy today. I'm considering. I had a nap. Cahill's ability to be happy is proportionate to how much sleep they've gotten. And I just slept. So, you make me happy too, Vegenta. So therefore, I'm doing pretty okay. Also, more sketches. They're really loading you up with sketches. Look at our health bar, look at the power-ups we have. It's like we progress through the game while keeping the core mechanics basically the same. Almost like it's the hallmark of good game design. Uh-oh. Oh, shit. Shitty game design. Fuck. Big makes me very happy. Many of you. We had a moment last night. Me and you, or me and, or him and you and Pig. Because remember what I said about sleep? Also, Pig has... Pig and I... Even though we started at the very same time, me and Mr. Pig just began to climb. If y'all aren't already following Pig, which I really doubt because I can see the analytics and I know how many people follow me and Mr. Pig at the same time. Pig has much higher quality streams than me. And I could argue that's because he's older and I'm a college student. But I'm just gonna say it's because he's a better streamer, because that's also probably true. So y'all should go check him out. Check him out and sub to him, because he has really good emotes, and even though his butt one got denied, everyone's butt ones get denied. So, people will never stop trying to put butts on Twitch, no matter what Amazon does. I'm having a really hard time. I went on about game design, and then I got the timing of this completely wrong. Saum? It's some pig. Crystal, you made me think I did a typo, because I do a lot of those most of the time. But no, some pig. Like Charlotte's Web. You know Charlotte's Web. Fuck. These do not stay long. They don't stay long enough. You couldn't read it right. Oh, I can just enter it from this side. That works. Nothing. Older, more confident, better hardware, better streaming environment, since I live alone. Here's the thing, right? I would definitely... Oh, that's from the movie? Wow, I'm just shitty. Oh yeah, are you ready to get into some deep lore that really sucks? It's really bad. Ready? Watch this. Oh wait, we're not doing that yet? Okay.
Glad to see you make it. This is the Fireworks Control Center. I used to launch awe-inspiring shows from here. Atop of each tower, there is a battery of deactivated rockets. Activate them by climbing each tower and energize the gem you'll find. Once all three are done, race back here and it'll be showtime. Even the blot won't stand a chance against the firepower. I'll distract him so that you can sail the cowers. Let me open up the doors for you.
So yes.
Triggered the show with the remote control. Be careful out there.
So that is Oswald's plan. And it's pretty cool if you ask me. Oswald's plan to beat the blot, now that basically plans A through C have failed, is we're gonna use a Disney style fireworks show like a missile barrage and just blow him up. He's like right above us right now, so he's just gonna blow him up. Well, I guess there's no going back now. I mean,
We could just ask Oswald to open the door again, but... Let's get to the top of that tower, Mickey. Silence? I'm just saying. There's some cool stuff in this game. And I count the fact that you use a Disney-style fireworks show to blow up a Eldritch entity is one of them. Vegenta has come to make an announcement. This is also very Heart of Darkness like, just the with the tentacles and whatnot. Zawarudo, I think I did this wrong. Ow, it's okay. I was probably a little late. Well, we should all make that announcement to Pig Vegeta. Pig, pretend that's from all of us. But anyway. So yeah. It's gonna be fun. Let's be honest. Fireworks. Everyone's like, what do I miss about the outside? I'd say fireworks are a pretty cool thing. Granted, a bunch of people decided to go beyond nuts with their fireworks show this 4th of July, but I think real fireworks show. Here's the thing, right? I never realized Oswald had so many chandeliers. Good thing the chains spinning them are so strong. Yeah, I mean, apparently they're the only thing working. The floor in this place is basically non-existent. Uh-oh. But anyway, what was I thinking of? Oh, yes. Also, I gotta say, Disney puts on fireworks shows like no other. I don't give them that much credit currently, but... I mean, I rarely see another fireworks show like the ones in Disney World. See, what did I say about the fucking floor? Oswald better fix up this castle when this is all done. Because, Lord in heaven, is this not up to code. I don't think it counts as OSHA, because no one's really working here. But still. It's not safe. I mean, you're not wrong. That being said, they probably get a bunch of fireworks on the cheap. I doubt if they had to drop $1 million to... Well, I say that, but Disney's rich as fuck. So, what do I know? Uh-oh. Hey, I'm not supposed to... Am I supposed to jump? Because I don't have control. Oh, there's the boy! I don't remember him being so powerful and scary. Mickey, please hurry. Hi, I'm Gus. I'm a little bitch. Wait, what? I didn't say that. Yes, you did. Pig also has an announcement. Are you two getting married? Is it finally happening? Is my fanfic coming true? Fanfic, tagged under Cahill Comics. Okay, well, I don't think we should drop down again. We'll just die. I hope they're like moving a kill plane up, because otherwise we'll just have to reset the level. That is a pretty good announcement. Oh fuck. This is pretty precaut. Remember how I was saying this was unsafe? This has gone from unsafe to fully precautious. Uh-oh. top of the tower. Also, each of these towers have a name, and they're like Misery, Agony, something like that. Every tower is named like that. I think it's Misery, Agony, and Sorrow. Top the tower are gargoyles that can rotate. You'll have to hit them by doing the thing. I'm painting their heads. You know, do the thing. You must face inward. Remember, gargoyles have to be painted to become active. Oh yeah, did I mention Satan? He's still here. Yeah, one is Missouri, one's Alabama, and the other is still just named Sorrow. Ah, sir, please. He's just gonna try and swipe at us.
Meow!
Ow! Mother! Can I just paint you? Apparently not. Ow.
Pew!
Are you cheering for Satan? Juice, what are you doing? We are a Christian channel. I'm just gonna be on the bridge. Ow. Oh, he shot a fireball. A black fireball. Goo Satan. Oh. I thought you said go Satan. Which is problematic for many reasons. Damn it. Oh, there's a chest. Life? Life. Man, it's a good thing he's big. Otherwise, this would be incredibly hard. He would probably be kicking my ass. But I'm Mickey Mouse. So power of friendship. Man, this is some Masters of the Universe stuff. He does not like that. You did it! The first batch of fireworks is on! Holy fuck, is that overkill? Oswald, seriously? You used to do this every night? Who restocked these? Let's go on the other two towers and set them up as well. What the? Camera? Okay. Camera? Okay. Camera was having a hard time there. But regardless, so yeah. We're setting up Oswald's missile barrage. It's going okay. You know, to be fair, Pig, if Disney asked you, hey, listen, we need you to kill Satan, we're gonna give you some fireworks to do it, you'd probably want all the fireworks. You know? Also, look, oh, it's my boys. I know you boys. Hello. Have you missed Papa? This is disturbingly reminiscent of the workshop I came into and destroyed the world in. Don't hurt Papa. He hurt Papa. Oh, wait, no, I'm fine. He just knocked me away. They never really listened to me anyway. Like, hey, yeah, I mean, Pig, listen, you make a point. Maybe the first batch of fireworks would be enough to kill him. But you don't want to give him another... But if it doesn't work, you don't want to give him a second chance. Like... I would just do it first try and guarantee he's gone. Because in case you haven't noticed, he's kind of wrecking shop right now. And we barely got that under control. In fact, I'm pretty sure the only reason he's not still trying to kill everyone is because he's like, I'm about to leave anyway. Why does it matter? Which is hubris. But we'll use that against him. Look at him just pouring. Ah. Oh, okay. Ah, no. Ah, no. Okay. Some of the timing on the plat... Ow. At least they have this set up so that you clearly... Should I not be... Am I... Wrong thing? No, right thing. Okay. Excuse me. Ow. But anyway. We got this under control. You want to enter... Oh, it's grief. Did they say the name to the first one? So I guess it's like agony, grief, sorrow. In case you didn't tell, this is upset Disneyland and dystopic Disneyland enough. The castle is named after some really messed up stuff. Well, not messed up, just sad, emo, moody. To be fair, though, Oswald's wife is dead, and he runs the place, so he can name it what he wants. There's a secret here. I can feel it. I can sense it. Something's not right. Oh, what did I say? What did I say? Also, the architect. This is the backgrounds in this game are cool. Gold pin. We have quite a few pins at this point. Incredible, Vegeta. What kind of food have you ordered? Would you like to say? Sir, rude! You are not making this place any safer, Mr. Blot. Seriously, dude? People live here! He's just like nasty. If I had to use a word, nasty would probably be appropriate. Blot attack. I wonder why they put that concept art there. Maybe it's because he's too busy being a dick. Zaw and cheesy sticks. I like me some Zaw. Oops. Didn't mean to press that forward. I like me some Zaw. I don't always get me some cheesy sticks. Do you just mean cheesy bread, or are we talking for some full mozz sticks? Some full-on mozzy boys. Oh great, now we have to go through this guy just being a jerk. Cheesy bread. Okay, yeah, I like me some cheesy bread. I won't turn my nose up at some cheesy bread. Fun fact, I've talked about this before on stream, or at least to Vegeta and Pig. I don't eat a lot of things that include mozzarella sticks. At one point, it got to the point where my mom was like, if you eat a single mozzarella stick, I will buy you a PS4. And I did, and she did. So, granted, I had saved up for a while, so she bought like half of a PS4. But still, that's why I have a PS4 now. I think this would be cool if it was like a Sonic level, you know? Like if there was a level in a Sonic game where you were running up a spirally tower and something was chasing you. They might have done that, but I doubt it went well, considering how Sonic games usually turn out. He's still here! You know, I didn't... Here's the thing, right? I expected him at the top of the tower again, but I didn't want him to be here. Nope. Mr. Gargoyle, please. Oh, he dropped off a friend. I have some answers to some of your friends. I will make them my friends. This is the answer. What is the question? The question is violence. The answer is yes. Someone make a meme of fucking Mickey holding a paintbrush and being like, peace was never an option. You can come near. Oh, nope. Wow. He's really making a lot of lads. Actually, I can do something about that. There. They're busy watching my funny cartoons. Nope, 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 nope. There we go. Eat that. Leave. I've lit the crystal. Gondor has called for aid. How many people make that joke? That was an impressive display of explosive. Like, seriously, this is overkill. This was for entertainment? Now we're just one more tower to climb.
Hi, Stitch. You went under to loss? So I guess it was sorrow, grief, and loss. In case you couldn't tell, Oswald's wife died. This should tip you off. Oh. No, we're on a time limit. This won't be fun. Hey, I know what fun is. This isn't it. This ain't it, Chief. Don't worry, everyone. Platforming is my middle name. Stitch. Water. Does that not happen to you when you touch water? Weird. Oh. That's just a fun other area to waste your time. In case you really wanted to just not spend your time really doing anything. Okay. Gotta get on this barrel. Gotta get on this barrel and wait. How are you guys? Minky. Minky is ink. It's... Is that true? That's interesting. A well-known fact, but Mickey was suggested by Walt's wife to be Mickey's name. Because originally, Walt was like, he's gonna be Mortimer. And his wife was like, that's a dumb name. That's a dumb, dumb sounding name. Here we go. This is a cute mouse and you picked a bad name for him. Name him Mickey. Name him Michael. Yeah. Walt was like, okay. Works for me. Hiya, Lumberzack. We're doing our best to finish this today. Ow. And also, Mickey gets hurt by water. Wicked Witch of the West style. An incredible rat by the name of Michael Mortimer Mouse. Michael Mortimer Mouse and Dylan Platforming Cahill. Has there ever been a more powerful duo? I doubt it. I highly doubt it. Michael J. Mouse III. And Dylan Awful Platforming Cahill. That's my second middle name. Did I not tell you? Oh, now we got full on flying buttresses. Hell yeah. All you gothic art nerds out there are really getting your fix today, aren't you? Oh, everyone's just gonna keep adding on to Mickey, huh?
Michael J. Mortimer Mouse, the third from the hit franchise.
Kingdonium Hearts. That's the full name of the series. Not a lot of people know that. Kingdonium Hearts. Wow. Seriously, why is this place so crumbly? There's a lot of things you don't want a castle to be. Crumbly is one of them. Magenta needs your attention. Some rude boys with some rude attitude. Don't hurt your brother. I said, don't hurt your brother! For painting. There we go. Third of his name, protector of copyright, destroyer of public domain. That rhymed, Pig. Great job. Pig, you win the award. And to be fair, it wasn't Michael J. Mouse who destroyed copyright. I mean, destroyed public domain. It was the people who own it. Which is a really dark twist on the idea, if you think about it.
the cutie award, because you're a cutie, Mr. Pig. No. Seriously, stop hurting your brother. Ugh. Wii's fun, but dang, if it doesn't hurt your wrist. Also, is there a secret out there? No, that's just how it came in. Okay. Dun, dun, dun. Gotta love the gothic remix. Yo. Spending time with you. Spending time with Pig? I agree. Well, I agree. King Master Michael Mortimer Mouse III, Esquire. That's right, he's a lawyer, bitch. Pig, Magenta Zach, what if next time we play D&D, like, I just come in and Tess introduces herself, and she's just like, Tesney Draco, Esquire. And in the 24 hours she's been away from the group, she's managed to get a law degree. Some deep backstory. Oh, another boy. This will go badly. Also, I need some heckin' health. Excuse me. Put a TV. To keep him alive, they're my friends. Oh no, he made him an enemy. He's no longer a friend. Boy, you're glitching him out. Get out of here. Also, you're not doing any damage. So even if you were glitching him out, you're definitely not helping, is the thing. There, he's good. Mathis gets knighted. 15 minutes he was shopping. He's very confused. And like, here's the thing, right? He becomes a knight, but he didn't want to be a knight. I doubt she has the mental capacity to become a lawyer. You'd be correct in that. An engineer? Maybe. A lawyer? Definitely not. Not her best area. Law and arguments. She would definitely punch someone at one point. Did he? Was Arazachiel being a dick? Oh, so this is going well. Pew! What a great sound effect. Oh my god, it doesn't feel right. Did I mention I'm part of the Celeste Protection Squad? Because I am. And I will kick Arazachiel's ass. And apparently I have the advantage in that for multiple reasons. Also, I forgot I need to add Unarmed Strike to my attack abilities. Yeah. Listen, it's the classic David versus Goliath. Tess, who is a full inch shorter than Arazachiel, also, we're talking about our D&D characters in case anyone wants to know. But Tess, who is a full inch shorter than Arazachia, who carries every weapon imaginable, while Tess basically fights with her fist. All fireworks are ready to launch. Back to the firework control tower. That went weirdly well. Something feel off? Something's off. I can feel it. M&M. Do you like M&M? So yeah. With my and Zach's powers combined, LeBlanc figured out what you were doing. I mean, it wasn't hard. Knocked out of the tower to keep you from getting back. Oh, and there goes the crystal. Oh, crystal! Hey, get that back! Oh no, I need to check. That's why I need to add it to my sheet, so I'm not just fucking. Oh, there he is. You don't take that. I swear to gosh, if you take that crystal, you motherfucker. But not a lot, but they can hit many times. That's good. That's actually true. I can already do a second. Oh fuck. I can actually already do a second round of damage with my on first level, which is. Oh, I got launched. Ah! Okay. We're okay. Oh! Hold the plot. Are you done? Sir, are you done? Did you just get. I climbed all the way up this tower. Oh, no music. Skydiver pin. I survived. No music. It's spooky times. Oh. Oh, fuck. Okay, well. The conditions are right. Okay. Pig, what are you? Are you a sorcerer? You're a sorcerer, right? Not just like a wizard or whatever. Am I correct in that? Wizard. Okay, what conditions do you need to do a party wipe? And I'm really interested in this, because if it's like, well, if I gather the right materials, I could just end the world. No, I don't think that should count. In fact, I'm gonna say that doesn't count, because you're not actually fighting. You're just, I don't know. You're basically doing story shit. Is there more gears I need? No, we're good. Close to each other. Okay, pig. First off, that assumes you hit that. I like how that assumes that you, that whatever spell you're gonna cast hits all of us. And second off, that also assumes that whatever spell you cast, ow, whatever spell you cast takes all our hit points down to none. You're making a lot of assumptions here, pig. Don't get me wrong, wizards are wicked strong, and I completely believe you can in a couple levels. Here's the thing, right? I don't doubt a wizard. Oh my gosh. Whatever. Tess will still kick your ass. This is why Tess is purely melee and an idiot. To counter out all the book smart jocks in the group. Oh, not jocks, wizards. Book smart nerds. Okay, Hill, you don't understand. I get it. Okay? Listen, I listen to Adventure Zone, okay? If you've listened to that, first off, the first season and fucking, I'm just gonna miss that pin. I don't know. You say that, but I'm still gonna go ahead and be like, eh. I think I can take him. Here's the thing, right? It's a glut. I mean, I think the idea of balancing wizards, even though it doesn't work super well in practice, is that they're glass cannons, you know? Like, yeah, sure, they can hit hard from a distance, but the moment you get up close, they're fucked. Which, to my understanding, is relatively true. You can make a beefy wizard, but that's not how they traditionally come. Also, was I supposed to do something? I guess the root is back here. Oh. Where's the wall? What's crumbling? Oh, a wall. But anyway. Yeah, this is the part I remember. A bunch of tentacles come out and make the thing disappear. The Warudo. So Pig, thanks for sending me that Yang Xiaolong, how to make, you know, character guide on. Center of gravity here is whack. Anyway, character guide on YouTube. Because here's the thing. The thing I'm keeping from Yang, like, even though I would say Tess is relatively cut, like, I mean, I took some of the numbers they were talking about, for sure. Ow. Eh. But regardless, listen, I'm not here to measure size. Anyway, but is she's dexterous. She's, and as a monk, she can move pretty fast. And especially the more she levels up, the more movement options she'll get. So basically, like, you know, she can dance around as she's punching people. So what I'm saying is, eventually, it'll get to the point where you're like, well, I just need to hit her with a spell. And it's like, oh, well, easier said than done. And that's still not necessarily me saying I could beat you as a wizard. I'm just saying that I have different advantages as a monk. This is some nerd-ass nerd talk. I'm sorry to everyone on the VOD who has to listen to it, even though they don't know about our campaign and don't know about these characters. But no, I totally believe you could, you have some spell that would fucking wipe everyone out. I feel like that's the reason you play wizards. Not just you, everyone. But it's also a reason I don't play wizards. Oh yeah. But to my understanding, many of the most powerful spells have dex saving throws. You know? They have, it's the kind of thing where it's like, okay, well, if you dex save, you take half damage. And Lord in Heaven, don't not dex save, because you'll die. So I get, so yeah, Pig, I guess if you wanna, oh wait, cutscene, give me a minute. Fireworks are ready. Great job. Batteries are dead. I'll play some in a jiffy. His one piece of mechanical expertise is replacing batteries.
It's not a statue.
That's Hortensia. What's left of her after we bottled up the blot. I'm sorry. I messed up.
You didn't mean to. For a while, I did mean to, the rocket. Never mind. I made my share of messes. Seems we both need forgiveness, Mickey. Wait, any more confessions?
No.
You didn't create the Mad Doctor?
No.
Kidnap anybody?
No.
Brain swapping.
Shake. Well, here, also, we're doing this now. Finished. Shit. Fuck. But anyway, what I'm trying to say is, also here Mickey goes. This is the last level. We'll do something else if this goes too short. But anyway, yeah, so Pig, what I'm saying is, I guess if you want to make an anti-Tess build for some reason, I don't understand why you would. I guess if you really don't like her that much, even though I was the one who decided, like, I wouldn't do PvP. But if you don't want to make, if you want to make an anti-Tess build, I guess just, you know, don't have any spells that let you dex save, because she'll probably pass those. I want her arm. Like, her actual arm? Like, the one she has now? Or her... Name him Vegeta. Also, Vor. Vor? Vor? Very interesting to study. She'll kick you. Okay, I have... Hey, Pig, you're Leonard! Pig, I've said this before. And this is a warning to you and Zach. So Zach, I guess if you don't want this to happen, what is it? Stop Pig from doing this. But Tess's current prosthetic is, like, you know, magically fused to her arm, right? If she loses this arm, I'm just gonna go full bullshit. Oh, here's guy. Mickey, boy am I glad to see you. I got separated from Oswald after the blot grabbed us and fully vored us. Seriously, Disney makes fetishes. I think we're inside the blot. See what I mean?
When the block grabbed us, I dropped the remote. Unless Oswald found it, it's gone forever. I'm sorry. From now on, I'll follow you, and I'll help wherever I can. Lead on. But anyway, so yeah, my character Tesney in Dungeons & Dragons right now has a prosthetic arm, but it's not like functionally, it's just for aesthetics right now. But what I'm saying is, if someone takes that off her or busts it up to the point where she would, in reason, need a new arm, I'm just gonna go hog wild and I'm gonna be like, okay, Zach and Pig, especially Zach, if Pig's the one who does it, I avoid PvP. Here's the thing, right? I think PvP is interesting if it's done right, but if most people in the party agree, like, hey, this is not gonna be fun, then I'm not into it. Like I said, I'm interested in it, but I wouldn't do it if no one else is gonna find it fun. Kind of like a Pokemon battle, you know what I mean? So, I am very excited for our first combat encounter this Sunday. Because it is this Sunday, right? We're doing a kind of... Also, that's my heart. That appears to be your heart. Yeah, I said that, Gus. Thanks. Don't be a bitch. That means the block can enter your world when he gains enough strength. You gotta take it back before that happens. But not to zero HP. That's fair. If we want to do like a sparring match, that could be cool. Oswald, he'll be okay if we can weaken the block. You gotta hurry. So yeah, Oswald's just kind of in his skin right now. And we're just on like a bunch of indoor pimples. Here's the thing, right? Okay, I can't read. This is literally the most intense level, and I'll explain as to why in a minute. But the thing about Dungeons & Dragons PvP, I think it'd be fun if both characters had a story reason to fight. That would be fun, right? I don't think it'll be fun if one character wants to fight and the other doesn't, or if both players are just like, hey, let's fight, okay, yeah, sure. I'll do my best. Vegeta, I'll do my best to save him. Died for obvious reasons? The obvious reasons are being fire. How many pimples can we pop in this room? Leonard, no. No, he's fine. Also, that's not Leonard. This is a new boy. Chinley! Just leave him there. I'm sorry. Vegeta, listen. We're about to blow the whole ass blot up, so even if I make these guys friends, they're not gonna survive, and I'm sorry about that. Like, they're basically his white blood cells, and we're about to blow the entire body to smithereens. So, he's not gonna go any. He's not gonna do well. None of these boys are. This is so sad. The essence of cartoon characters is consumed by the blot. So here's the thing. These are the last enemies you meet in the game. They are invincible, unredeemable, and they're just like cartoon character models you'd meet in the real world. And this is actually one of the few in kind of almost like in-game morality checks. The bigger you of a dick you are to different people, the more of these guys will be in here, which has some dark implications in a lot of way. But yeah, I remember the best strategy for just avoiding them is to just walk on the tentacles and they can't get up here to reach you. Because like I said, they are completely undefeatable. But I would like to say, I think up here, oh my gosh, they're literally zombies. But I think they're cool just as like a final enemy encounter of just like, hey, how big of a dick you are to people. We'll measure that in unkillable enemies. Leave me alone. Leave me alone, sir. Sir? Sure. There they go. You did it! One blotsicle down! Looks like the lost characters melted when the blotsicle was destroyed. I hope they freed them somehow. Gus, this is so sad. Can we get 50 likes? Guys, can we get, like, I don't know, 2 followers on this stream? Just 2 viewers on this stream? If we do, oh shit. That is the end of the sentence. Done. Like I said, this is
like I, this area is the one that where it gets tough, because they're like, hey, it's been a pretty easy kids game for the entire thing. This is the last level. You have 9 viewers, so okay, I'll shit later. Yeah, later. I didn't say when. Look how blocks spawning defenses. Those spatters are like it's antibodies. I literally said that. I didn't even remember that was a something they said. Also, I'm gonna melt some of these boys, because here's the thing, I'm gonna need help. Actually, let me Zawarudo. I have to be really careful not to hit Chinle, or else he'll blow up. Yeah, we did get totally bored. We are inside someone. No, I don't want these. Also, let me get away from Chinle real quick. I don't want these. I want fucking health. I really do need some health. And if anyone could provide for poor little Michael Mouse. There they go. This is going badly. Oh, hey, look. It's the first one of the green ones we've gotten. Let's use it immediately. Bitch, who the fuck told me not to do any more night specials? What do you mean night specials? I don't even know what that is, Magenta. Also, we got some health. Yeah, the final level of this game is bore. The final level in this game is confronting the fetishes Disney gave us when we were kids. Which, I mean, is pretty thematic. Oh, I didn't even know you had to beat all of them. I was just trying to get health. Alright. Magenta, a new one. Let's see. Okay. It pulled. Are they cheering? Someone said no. I wasn't even on your Discord, Magenta. I mean, I am on your Discord, but I didn't see the poll. So, slow your roll there, buddy. Hey there, pal. You seem to be jumping to conclusions. Well, let me just say, that can make your legs sore. Ow. I've been hurt. I've been injured. Cletus. Oh, okay, that one's name was Cletus. I thought it said Cletus. Cletus the Deletus Fetus. More zombies. The only way I get exercise. That is fair. And you want to know something, Magenta? You're valid. I don't think TVs distract us, these guys either. Which is a weird sentence to say when you're in the middle of a... You know... Listen, I don't mean to be the type of guy to be like, well, this Disney thing is actually pretty dark. This is like SCP levels, specifically the Flesh That Hates levels of like disturbing imagery. Of just like, hey, there were characters that lived here once. They've been consumed and are just part of the organism now. They're just like in it, you know? Oh, and by the way, if you don't get yourself and your friend out, the same thing will happen. Got one more to go. Ding. If I get a chance to do my junior film, which I'm hoping I will. Ow, I got squished. Yeah, when I was a kid, I died in this level pretty often. I can't even super remember where I died a lot in this game when I was little. This part for sure. This part definitely. Okay, we got 2 watch sketches. Ow. Sir, please. Ow. I'm getting knocked around. Who knew bodies were just so squishy? In every sense of the word. In every sense of that disturbing, disturbing word. Also, it's dark. Dark as all get out. Yeah, that's right. Flail your tentacles at me. I know what aliens are like. Well, I guess he's not an alien, technically. He is technically an alien, I guess, because...
Oh no, he's summoning more defenses. These ones are bigger dicks.
CBH, I never made it past the Mad Doctor, so I didn't know this part existed. I feel like some people didn't get past the first level because people were like, the camera sucks. And I'm like, I mean, yeah, kind of. It's a 3D platformer. That's indicative of the genre in it sometimes. Okay. Hey guys. I really need that. Thank you. Hey guys, once again, just want to come in here. I really need that. Okay, wow, their aim is incredible. Their aim is impeccable. Maybe I can just take him out from here. Actually, I could use him. I have to, wait. I only alerted the one, I didn't mean to spray them all. Here they go. There goes my sweeper. Has there been a Minecraft parody of that song yet? And if not, when is there going to be? There goes my creeper. Watch him as he blows. Are there no checkpoints? No, there are. If there wasn't, it'd be incredibly hard. It'd be really hard. But that was just a checkpoint just now. So, we only have one tentacle left to go. And then we have the main room. And then that's the end of the game. Also, they reset Chinley! Chinley, you were a friend a minute ago. There you go, Chinley. Magenta, you don't get to name him twice. I'm sorry. Ow. Great welcome to this part of the plot. Glad to be here. I don't know what it would feel like. I did not think that platform would go all the way down. Anyway, I don't know what it would feel like to have a small mouse inside you, injecting you with what is basically pure life and pure death, but it's probably not great. Like, I can't blame him for being upset, you know, in theory. I can blame him for all the other shit he does, but the fact he's upset about me doing this isn't really that shocking. You'd be surprised. Magenta, have you had that experience? Is that a Friday night for you? Magenta's Fridays get pretty wild. I don't mean to brag, but...
Just one more blotsicle to eliminate, then you can take your heart back. Only then will your world be safe from the blot.
Saturday, actually. That makes sense.
We got the one left, boys! This is final boss.
I guess, technically. We're gonna bust out all the tricks. All the moves. All the shim sham cherries. It's funny that this game was supposed to be even darker than it is now. Yeah, but in some ways I'm glad they toned it down. There's like some error, because I know, trust me, when this is the only game you have as a kid growing up with the internet, you find out plenty of trivia. Also, I had the art book, so I found out plenty against it. But like, there are some things I'm glad they toned down, because one was like, Oswald's gonna be a villain and try to kill you and you kill him. I'm like, that's not great. But, you know, some of the environmental stuff, I think it'd be cool if it was plenty darker. Like, that'd be fun.
There's one more, and there's the pimple. Get the pimple pot. Mickey, I can't believe I'm saying this. We've been on quite a journey together. Get to fucking popping those pimples.
Also, there he goes. Oh no, they're surrounding him. Okay. So there's no point in defeating them anymore. Got it. Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on. Zawarudo. So even if I kill that guy, he's just gonna respawn infinitely. That's bad. Hey fellas, I don't know if you know what bad is. That's bad. I'm just gonna put this here. Y'all, no, uh-oh. He absorbed it. That happens sometimes, you know? Sometimes you put on TV for your kids and they absorb it. They absorb it, they absorb it. And he's trying to absorb me. But this is the circle of life. Ow, okay, I died. Circle of life, circle of death. Okay, Chinley might explode. It's all come full circle for him. I'm sorry, Chinley. We have to try and do these as remotely as possible. We're gonna have to paint snipe these, because otherwise we're gonna be real deep in it. No, yeah, you know, you kept saying that, Magenta, and I was like, he's not gonna die, and then he died. You fulfilled your own prophecy. Watch your TV, kids. Don't pay attention to Daddy. Don't pay attention to Daddy. Don't pay attention to Dad. Don't pay attention to Daddy Michael Mouse. And there goes, I forget his name already, I'm gonna be honest. I'm not gonna lie to you, I forgot that one's name. Colin? I feel like it was Colin. It wasn't Colin. Let my fucking heart go, you bitch. Leonard. Oh, you're right. It was Leonard. I feel like you named another one Leonard. It's a curse of mine. What, to watch your children die? Bitch! You're gonna have to get up high for the final shot. Well, good thing I'm here. Hey, Blot. Look at me. Bitch. Up. Bitch. Did it. That's the game, fellas. Time. And time. This is a nice cutscene. Michael Mouse, 2020. I'd vote for him. Aw. Hey, I want my heart back. I do kind of need that. This is a very Disney ending, and I love it. Super cinematic, too. Whee! Time for a show, boys. Ow, 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 ow! There he goes. Oh yeah, this is the part I was telling y'all about. And noticed something has changed. The wasteland no longer needed my magic. I like how you can see the area the projector screens were in. It had developed some magic of its own. Magic. Everything's getting better. Yeah, this is the point where he just kind of... I mean, he made his choice. He was like, I'm good here forever. And of course, the luck of a certain cartoon rabbit. Oh, shit. Good thing she was made of stone for that. Oh, never mind. She's good. Leave! Funny thing about mirrors. That is correct. Us to reflect. So yeah. Each of these there are different amounts of cutscenes for each choice you made. Small Pete. Or avoided. How well we managed. Clock Tower. Enemies defeated or Captain Hook.
Beatronic. Nice, Henry. There's Gus.
Oswald and Mickey are, in some ways, each a mirror for the other. Brave, resourceful.
Is haunting. Everyone keeps saying that. That's sweet. And then we get to watch the credits. So that was my favorite game of all time. Thanks, Argenta. What you guys think? That's my favorite game ever. Oh, fuck. Who didn't, is the question Argenta would ask. Producer, please clarify. I think you're cute, Magenta. Also, can we skip these? I don't necessarily want to skip them, but at the same time, I do want to get to art. Not that I'm doing art today. Oh, I can't. We'll wait for a minute. Y'all have a good time? Have a good time watching this? This doesn't necessarily have to be over. I have another thing lined up if you guys want. It's still a pretty good game. I agree. Oh my gosh. Doo-doo. Those things are disturbing. I love how they just have little cartoon splatters. Okay. I'll appreciate the artist, but I think we should move on. More Cahill stream. I have something. I gotta plug in a thing real quick, but after that, we can start other thing. But real quick, let's take a look at the concept art. I promised that this at the beginning. So, extras. And then, so yeah, it just starts you out at the beginning again. This little thing, this is the, if you start up the game again, you'll get the first cutscene. You're in an infinite loop. So we got over half. And we missed. Also, yeah, I won't show them to you because the VOD will absolutely get destroyed. But there's different cartoons. You can watch an old Mickey Mouse cartoon, the one that the Mad Doctor, the second antagonist of the game, came from, or one of the Oswald cartoons. Which, Crystal Rivers, I believe, if you're still here, you said this, you have the collection of Oswald cartoons in a tin. I do as well. I have all the Oswald cartoons. Because here's the thing. They don't know where some of them went, but all the ones they could find got put onto a special collection. They actually found another Oswald cartoon for... So yeah, let's look at some of this. Uh-oh. I thought you could just scroll. You cannot. But what is it? So these are just like Mickey concepts. I don't know why they had... They made Mickey character sketches. I don't know why. Do they not have enough reference material of Michael Mouse? Also, a concept art of Mickey with his inky effect. So you want to know something? If you notice the date, that's like 1920, it should say 1928. This was sketched onto a letter from Walt Disney to his replacement at Universal when he left the Oswald cartoons. This is the only drawing Walt Disney has ever made to ever exist of both Mickey and Oswald in one image. Yep, it exists somewhere, and there are scans of it, so. Then some Oswald sketches. Oswald, I understand why they need character sketches. Some of the bunny children. Ooh, that gets rough. The crocodile from Ventureland with, what was I thinking of? Animations for spatters as they... the like spawn in animation.
some different versions of the Pete from Tomorrow City. Then they have like some fully like those are sketches. Then they have some fully colored pieces. I like that one of just like Mickey and Gus chasing down Oswald. One of the things in here, have you considered? You cute? No, you pig. No, you. Blot. More blot. Oh yeah, that one. That I think this one's cool. It's a good. I like the silhouettes they make of Mickey. It's a small world level, very first level, Lonesome Manor passage. That looks more like Mean Street. Oh, so yeah, these are. I would say, you know, it doesn't have as much atmospheric lighting, but this is pretty close to what the actual product was. But this is the art style that definitely drew a lot of people into the game. Hortensia's house, Oswald's throne. Also, this is another one of my favorite pieces, where it's just the. Stream broke. I mean, stream didn't actually break. Is it gone? Okay, no. That was fully gone. What? Seriously, some of these are weirdly edgy and weirdly cool. This one I love. I know some of these. And yeah. Also, this was made by one of the cast kids. And then this is actually what I'm using for the thumbnails for the VODs. Epic, Mickey. Anyway, so if y'all would like to stick around, I can switch to Cuphead. Because that'll be the first available one. And then next time we start, next time we do a game stream, we'll be doing most likely Horizon Zero Dawn, because Pig made a donation and asked that. Coupod. So yeah, what was I thinking of? Some more cartoon themed antics. Give me a second, I'll boot that up. I think I'll actually, for right now, we're gonna go black screen. Ready? Boop! There it goes. You should still be, yeah, you can hear me. Oh, okay. I was checking on some personal matters. Play. Give me a second, and then I need to make a new scene. Window. Okay. Which window? Give me Cuphead. Size it down. Size it down. Size it down. Too big. Too big. Too big. Too big. So professional. I'm such a professional streamer. Too big. Rip. I mean, honestly. I am playing it windowed. Because fucking. And then. There. Should be good. Behind the scenes. Oh, this needs to go down some. Is that okay for everyone? It pauses whenever I click off of it.
Well, Cuphead and his pal Bug Man, they like to roll the dice. By chance they.
And then it pauses again. Okay, volume's good.
They came on Devil's Game.
Give me a minute.
Gosh, they paid the price.
Where's my hecking controller?
The price.
I ain't playing this with a fucking. And I can't play with a Wii remote. That's not happening.
Dread. And if they proceed but don't succeed.
There it is.
The devil will take their heads.
Please. Spare me. I don't know what's happening. I don't know what's happening in my own chat. Is that good? Is it working? It's not working. Wait. Steam, are you gonna work for me? Okay. This worked last time I tested it. Was it in the other one? Uh-oh.
This is, theoretically, here's the thing. Theoretically, this should be working. Options. Wait a minute. Is it? Okay. Am I just gonna have to? Cause I can't. I really can't play this. Has anyone played? Okay, wait. Start. Op. Controls. Assign to There we go. Okay. We're good. That's my. Let's do Mugman. I've never played as Mugman before. Mugman time. Pigs, Vegeta's just trying to improvise fucking. Vegeta's just trying to improvise emotes. Oh, I didn't realize I had to scroll. I thought this was auto scroll, which is one reason I wasn't narrating. You guys get the idea. Blah, blah, blah. Children were gambling. Satan showed up. Why do we keep running into Satan in these cartoon games? They took a bet and they lost, and that sucks. They were like, please don't kill us. He was like, I mean, if you do some shit for me, maybe. Get out of here. They were like, okay, let's go ask her dad for help. Satan's a pretty good villain. I mean, he is the villain. Bye, Zach. I love you. What a fine pickle. Why am I Gus? Sure, why not? What a fine pickle you boys have gotten yourself into. I know you don't want to be Pond of the Devil, but if you refuse, I can't bear to imagine your fates. You must play along for now. I'll collect. Oh, wait. Oh, shit. Fuck me. I just realized I could get in trouble for not changing the thing. New. Pause that. I forgot that was a thing Twitch cares about. I don't know why I had these drugs, like, just ready to go. Okay. That's pretty good. This works out. I don't want to exit cross. What's heaven, too? Like, it's heaven, but, like, twice? You do twice as much good shit to get in there. Are there extra coins? You gotta check everywhere for secret coins. Secret coins? Secret coins? Secret coin? Secret coins. Secret coins. Do you have a secret coin? Hey, fellas. Looks like you're in for it now, eh? Well, I used to be the same way. I was getting into trouble. Running, jumping, shooting. But now, I prefer just strolling around and going into the pictures. But hey, let me give you a hand. Take this. Sweet. Secret coins. Yeah. I'm a coin. No one's gonna get my coin. Regular, because I'm no simp. I ain't a simp. Let's do this. I'm pretty good at this game. Oh, I tried to parry that. You cannot hurt me, potato. Okay, you hurt me, potato man. Ow, okay, this is going. No, you know what? No. I decided I wasn't gonna let it go that bad. I'm upset. Because first thing, I hit parry on that worm. I am okay with getting hit once or twice. I just need to go get the auto parry. There we go. Fuck you, potato. Guys, who are you gonna kiss in the secret tunnel? My future wife.
Stop crying. What's your name? Onion the bitch? Oh!
Hello, psychic hair.
Yeah, contact damage kind of sucks. The thing that annoys me about it in every video game, like even just like simple things like Mario, is the fact of like, you get hurt, but the enemy you touch doesn't. And I don't understand how that works or why it's fair. Ow. I'm gonna get a bad score for this. But hey. Oh, fuck. Great. The enemy touches you. We're gonna do good. Watch. This is an S run, for sure. Now to unload on this onion. Seriously, do you add anything of value to this game? Thanks for the wording, Kale. Don't even worry about it. Just really get deep in that onion. Give it to him. And I gotta stop this carrot from getting deep in me, if you know what I mean. We've all been there, right, fellas? When we're playing Cuphead. For most systems. Also, I got hit, so not an S run. But hey. Sweet. Egg! First boss done. That was the devil, right? That's all we have to do, and now we can kill the devil? Got it. Got it. Got it. Did great. Great. Skill level. A minus. I'll take it. I did worse than that in school. Well, I still passed. Jump? The root pack. More like the Krump. I'll be a monkey's uncle if I'm putting my moolah on the bank. For all I know, the devil probably controls that place too. I'll never get a hold of my gold if I spread it all around. If some Joe happens to find a coin or two, good for him. That's what I say, Krump. Okay, Boomer. I'll say, okay, Golden Boomer. Just hanging around. Where's I know there's some secret coins. See ya, pig. We'll be back later, maybe. Okay. Well, I'll do my. I'm definitely trying to stream more, so. No, not for. Not yet. Not that yet. Oh, wait. Secret coin. Secret coin? Secret coin. Nah, damn it. Fine. Everyone should love Pig. Can we get some love in the chat for Pig? Goopy Legrand in Ruse of a News. What incredible names. What incredible names these have. These levels have. I forgot how far he jumps. Oh. I don't like the default button layout. Damn it! Oh, damn! Okay, nope. Trying again. He's very friend-shaped. This is true. We're still gonna kick his ass, though. Also, I love the background.
Much like Mayo the Otter, this thing is very friend-shaped. But we still must fight him. Why must we fight? I'm not doing well at this. I remember, like, really customizing the control layout because I didn't like the default ones, and right now, I didn't take the time to do that before playing this. So, I did. I don't even want a good score. I just want to not be shit. Also, fun fact, I animate all my stuff, even though I don't animate much all the time. I animate all my stuff the same way this game is animated. And that's one reason I love this game. Here's the thing, right? I like Cuphead. It's not necessarily like my favorite. I take back what I said. I take back the love I had. Please exit the map and read. No! We're doing this! I've worked with broken controllers before. And also, I'm just being stupid. I'm not really focusing. He makes little sounds. I swan to John, Goopy LeGrand, if that even is your real name. I'm beating this fella, with or without my custom control scheme. Did someone just oh, they followed. Thank you. Wait, let me just... XS space HSH 1R4. I feel like that says Sharon. Is it just XX Sharon XX? Is that a fun way to spell that? Oh, fuck. You need the dash here? And the problem is, I don't like where the dash is on the default control. That's my biggest problem, is that the dash is in a weird place. See, I hit the dash when I meant this. There we go. It just has, and also their drop is just 2 frames, which must be fun. Do I get a B? I feel like I get a B. Yeah, that's, that figures. See, Vegenta, what'd I tell you? We're fine. It's fine. Cuphead? Did that say Mugman or Cuphead? Did they change that? Mugman did get added in a patch, so. Running gun. Correct. I'm really glad they stuck to keeping it primarily boss fights. Are you dropping frames? I honestly seems like... Am I? Well, I can't... Hey, but so here's a fun thing. I can't tell. Because it's... No? My bitrate's good and everything. My bitrate's better than normal, actually. So it shouldn't be me dropping frames. Theoretically. And also, isn't this done at 30 FPS? No. Also, I just realized I don't need to be staying here. It's not a boss fight. I can do what I want. I can go where I want. I can do as I please. Okay. Nowhere to run, nowhere to go. Everyone in this forest is your foe. What fun rhymes these murderers have. You know what, Vegenta? If you want a good platforming, go watch Good Platforming the channel. That's what their name is. I'm pressing the first thing I'm getting is the auto parry. The first thing I'm getting is the auto parry. I want to get the boomerang shot, and hopefully I can. I'm getting the auto parry, though. There we go. Never stop shooting. Just never stop. Always be going. Always be shooting. Why? Why though? You know, I realize, despite all the, like, upgrades you get, you never get a way to regain health, do you? No! Damn it! That was the control scheme! I'm not fixing it. I'm not fixing it. Now I'm stubborn. Now I'm stubborn. I have to keep the shitty default control scheme. If I ever come back to Cuphead on stream, I'll do it. No, I'm not. You can't make me, Vegeta. Also, half of it's just me bitching. I'm not even paying attention. Trust me, fixing it wouldn't make me that better. I'm talking to people as I'm playing. Historically, the Let's Player excuse for not being able to play games. There we go. Ow. I like how you just pop the blueberries. They don't die, they just pop. Okay, let's do this again. There we go. Excuse me, sir. Sir? Mr. Blueberry, sir? Here's the thing, right? So each of the running gun levels have like a mini boss you fight. That acorn machine, as it's so... Oh no. Oh no. Sir, please. Sir, please. I didn't mean to. Okay. Well, that wasn't the control scheme. That was me being shitty at a game. Let's Player gets stuck on for dumb streamer. I'm just making Vegeta. Here's the thing, right? I believe there's four other people watching right now. Statistically, unless they're just not speaking up, I'm only making Vegeta angrier. Which is funny to me, because he's done that enough to me live on the air. Literally yesterday. Literally yesterday. Juice is here somewhere. Well, you know what? That's good. I'm just retrying because that was just bad. That was sad. It was sad. Is Juice a she? I never know. And to be honest, it's not super important to me. But, what is it? I watched this go down, so I'm content. Well, maybe if you're curious, it's good to ask. Because here's the thing, right? I'm gonna shit. That's my new catchphrase. Do you like it? I'm gonna shit. Cahill Comics. First line of merch. I'm gonna scream. But what was I thinking of? I am goal person, yes. Well, here's the thing, right? Like I was saying, it doesn't matter to me. But obviously, there are many people who are completely valid in wanting people to call them the correct thing. So I'm pressing the pink button. I don't know what you want. I do all the pink things, yet you do not give me the... This isn't even the control screen. I'm doing the thing. I press the button. The game does not go. Good question. Let's really dive into a discovery of identity. Also, wait. What emote is that? Is that a pixel... Is that a Pixel Pit emote, Juice? I do like me some Pixel. Here's the thing, right? I followed Pixel Pit because I love his animation so much, and then he stopped animating. And I'm not gonna blame him for that. He should do whatever he enjoys. I'm not gonna make him animate, but I'm saying it's ironic. But I still support him because he seems like a nice dude. Statistically, you stop. Statistically, also, I'm subscribed to him on Twitch. I don't think he's live. If he was, I might rate him. But that's the thing, right? If someone's a cool person, I still want to support their endeavors. I can make it. He says famously. Okay. He's live. Oh no, maybe we should we raid him? What if I can get past this level? Magenta, don't give me sass. I'll try and go to like at least 3. And if no one extra shows up, if like Chen doesn't pop his head in at 3 and is like, "Hello," then we'll raid Robin. If we get some extra lurkers, that's great, but Usually I end stream based on how active chat is. You jumped into the blueberry. You deserve that. At sass. I mean, I'm not saying I don't. I hate. You know, Cuphead's a great game. And there were some people who were made fun of for criticizing it at the start. And rightly so, I'm gonna shit. Rightly so, because they were making some pretty dumb criticisms. You're up. But here's the thing, is the parry mechanic is still pretty stupid. And maybe I'll catch some flack for that. But the way the parry mechanic works is you fling yourself into danger, right? Assuming the danger is pink colored, which is the only indication they've given you that you're not gonna die, right? And then, to stop yourself from being hurt, what you do is you press the jump button another time, akin to a double jump, right? The thing is, though, if it's not at just the right time, you get hurt. Now, you might be like, well, this is just an extra thing. Surely you can go without that one mechanic. There are definitely levels and bosses where you need the parry mechanic. You need it in order to... Nope. Okay, I can just shoot above. I forgot I could shoot above me. I was going... My mind just went full Mega Man, and, like, for a second, I was like, I cannot shoot above. Only to side. Only side to side. Oh, my gosh. I didn't parry that time. I don't blame the game for it, but... Side? Side. I mean, we are back in the mine. And we do... And we do have our pickaxe swinging from side to side. And this task is a grueling one. But I don't know. Is a creeper gonna take all our stuff tonight? Also, I love the little rhythm your little pea shooter has. Just click, click, click. Makes click. I can't even replicate it with my mouth. Because it's just... Okay. Okay. There we go. I'm taking juice right now. As in, you're drinking juice, or you're taking the person juice from my chat and placing them somewhere else? Because I'd rather you not, if I'm being honest. I like juice. I like it when they're here. See, that's me doing the thing. I just... even though I just found the information juice out is probably Gore... Juice's Gore person... I'm still going with they, because they is an incredibly safe thing to call someone. Unless someone is, like, really adamant about being called one thing, they is a pretty safe bet. Yeah, Juice, you're sweet. You're sweet like Juice! Okay. Okay, we're like in the last stretch. I have to be able to do this. Okay. No, don't fire. Don't fire, mushroom person. There we go. Good mushroom person. Hey, we did it. Hey, what'd I tell you, Magenta? No problem. No problem. See, he's encouraging me. Also, I probably got a shitty grade on that. Oh my gosh, guys, I didn't tell you. Wait, how many people are here? How many people are here? This is big news. Guys, this is big news. Okay. Guys, we have 69 followers. Come on. Give it up. 69 followers on the channel. Everyone give it up. Oh, hell yeah. Nice. Nice. Can we? Ah, hell yeah, Juice. Nice, dude. Nice. Yeah, we did it. That's the end. I'm done. Done, Twitch. No more Twitch. That's it. Thanks for everything, guys. We did it. We did it. Bye. Thank you. Thank you. Does anyone actually like those audio gags, or do I just do them for myself? Cross. Pork person. Vegeta 2. Vegeta the second. Welcome. Auto parry? Where's auto parry? I'm getting the roundabout. I use it the most. Where's the auto parry? Not an extra heart. Let's get smoke screen. I can't get it. I love audio bits, to be honest. Okay. Well, as long as it's not totally hate it, I'll keep doing them. Does it actually sound like I'm walking out? Because I was walking out as I did it. This is, as far as first area boxes go, these guys suck the most. I do not like them. Oh, I'm already confused. Oh, the already confused with the control screen. Oh, fuck. Forgot you had to duck. I didn't get it in time. I'm sorry, Vegeta. I really tried. I was looking for it. Also, I love these little firefly designs. I forgot it does that. Damn it. No, you know what? I'm not even going to make it. I can tell you right now, this is the kind of boss where if you don't have most of your health... I meant to be pressing backwards. Damn. Well, nuts to me. Am I right? I just make little boops. I won't reset, but I will be upset. Okay. I keep forgetting to duck. I keep forgetting to duck, duck, and goose. Damn it! It just switches off! I should switch the controls. Listen, if I do another Cuphead stream, I'll switch the controls. But I just... It's a lot of work for one stream. Vore? Is it Vore time? Oh, it's Vore time, lads. Please, stop. Sir, stop it. Stop spitting coins at me. Uh-oh. This is why I have this for this fight, because at one point, you just gotta focus on platforming, and you can't even care about where you're shooting. Which is an interesting boss design, and by interesting, I mean shitty. I love the balls. Okay. Wonderful! Great. Damn it. Awesome. I feel like you're getting more upset than I am, Vegeta. Welcome to the second half of the Cuphead stream, where Vegeta gets more upset about Cahill's Cuphead playing than he does. Maybe you need to learn to chill, Vegeta. Did you ever think about that? I bet you didn't. Did you think to chill, Vegeta? Just a little bit? Maybe you should learn to get good. Well, that goes without saying. But I'm trying to give you friendly advice. Ow. What hit me? Okay, you can't... Okay, well, that was just me being stupid. But that second one, why did I get hit? Why did I get hit? Would someone like to, would someone at MDHR like to explain that to me? I already told, okay. You know, I was about to say these guys suck, but maybe I'm just the one who sucks. Maybe I am who sucks. Okay, yeah, maybe I am the one who sucks. Do people not come to Twitch for really bad Cuphead gameplay? I don't understand why I'm not the most popular channel right now. I guess we just need to hit it and run, because if we stick around for longer than half a second, we will die. What, that I am the one who sucks? What if it's just true, Vegeta? What if I am the one who sucks? Damn it. Okay, yeah. This is what sucks about this boss, because you get to that last phase, and all of a sudden, it's non-stop RNG shit. Among other shitty things. Okay. Apparently that's too far off screen. No! I had it set to boomerang. I don't know why it was like, we're just gonna do pea shooter. We're just gonna do pea shooter? We're just gonna do pea shooter. Pea shooter is good. Let me shoot your pea. Sir, your pea. Let me shoot it. You want to know something? I unironically hate this one more. This one right here. That's not even a joke, just because I'm shooting him right now. I just don't like him the most. I don't know what it is about him. I just don't enjoy him. We're gonna beat this bot. I'm not quitting stream until we beat this bot. How far is that though? Also, my stream is looking chunky. He streams at 5, doesn't he? That'd be a long ass stream. And I don't mind a long ass. I'm trying to do a longer stream as of right now, but that's still pretty long. So, what was I thinking of? The thing is, one reason I started doing streams earlier is because, and I believe I said this on stream, but still, it would be good to tell people again that I cannot work in my office downstairs anymore. It is too hot, and I was having problems with the Wii down there, so I switched to up here. But along with that comes the fact that my family can hear everything I do on stream. And I'm doing it earlier so that I can just do it while they're out. And I don't have to worry about whatever I'm doing. Don't spit coins at me. Don't spit coins at me. Ow. Why would you do that? I make the weirdest facial expressions while I do hard platforming. I'm not even joking. My face just contorts in ways that are unnatural for most human beings. I literally can't believe. Okay, there we go. Fuck you, frogs. I'll at least go to, like, over 2 hours. I'll do my best. I don't think I really want to get to, like, the... See, and Vegeta didn't even die. I don't really think I want to get to, like, the second aisle. I'm not trying to do the whole game right now. But... I believe the other day I was like, I can do a Cuphead stream. I can probably beat it in one stream. That's true, but that's if I, like, started it and did a longer stream and then finished it. You know what I mean? Give me the shoot 'em up blueprints. Mine. Give it to me. What's that? You two want to fly like a plane like I do. You're not sitting in any cockpits till you study those blueprints. Okay. Well, you don't have to be an ass about it. At least this one works easier. Away! Yep, exit. Cross. Oh, my neck hurts. I'm not in a comfy gamer chair. I'm just sitting upright on the end of my bed. Simple and clean. Threatening Zeppelin. A brawl is surely brewing. A brawl in my ass. Ma'am, excuse me. Oh, okay. Can someone clip? Do y'all see what's right in front of Bugman? Yeah, retry. I have a feeling I'll have to, no matter what button I press. I've played Cuphead through, I think, twice. Once on the Switch, once on the computer. I don't recognize that constellation from my observatory class. Damn it. You ever just, like, know you have to go somewhere, but don't know, like, in a shoot 'em up? You're just like, I need to go somewhere, but I really don't know where. And it's not even impossible, but, like, you just don't know where what's the right direction anymore. Also, does everyone realize this boss's name is Hindenburg? You know, it was a long time ago, but I deserve that. To a degree, I deserve that. Where is it going? Where is it coming from? Where did it come from? Where did it go? Where is it coming from, Cotton Eye Joe? Cotton Eye Joe, give us your walkthrough of Cuphead. Is she about to do more shit on top of her machine gun bullshit? That's not fun. Hey, Hindenburg, you're not fun. I mean, you are, actually. I really like this boss, but... Wait, what? 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 That doesn't make sense. I didn't pick easy, did I? What happened there? See, okay. Wait. It hadn't been for Cotton Eye Joe. I'd be married for a long time. What happened? Did I get that? Oh, okay. So apparently I picked easy by accident. I didn't even mean to. No. Give me that regular difficulty. I ain't no wuss. I ain't no wuss. I'd make a Matador joke, but I feel like those are in poor taste. Anyone who's watched the Book of Life knows what I'm talking about. They don't teach you that as a kid. Apparently being part of the Matador is killing a bull? That's not fun. I mean, arguably it was never fun for the bull to begin with, but... It's double not fun when they have to die. She does it in two. She does it in two, clockwise and counterclockwise. Why did she turn into a zodiac? I don't know. Ask her. Listen. She's the flying boss. There's multiple flying boss, but she's the first flying boss. I could ask what's up with her whole design, if I'm being honest. Like seriously, what is going on here? This next part is just a crescent moon. Uh-oh. When are you guys gonna fire off your lasers? Uh-oh. We're very close. Okay, there we go. Fuck you. Fuck you. You thought you'd get off easy? Nah. Mugman's here to play! Top grade, C. B! Oh, new high score. You don't say. Hildeberg. Much yep, I do not want to do this.
Now go.
No, not retry exit. Listen, I know Vegeta suggested raiding Pig, but I'm tired. We finished the game, we beat some few levels in Cuphead. I think this might be the end of the stream. I thank you all for coming. But this is definitely... But, what is it? I'm sorry, Vegeta. We're gonna raid someone, though. Who are we gonna raid? I have to... The fact that no one... Vegeta, don't be sad, because Invizo's streaming. And I just followed him yesterday. So let's go raid Invizo. Are you really gonna be sad we're gonna raid Invizo? Are you really gonna be sad about that, Vegeta? He's Invizo guy. Yes, okay. Well... I'll tell Invizo you said that. Also, I didn't want to pause Cuphead. It did it by itself. Raid channel. We're going to raid. But I love you. You're all the best. Thank you for joining me for my journey through Epic Mickey. Thank you, Juice, for coming. I'm going to try and stick to a schedule more often. I'm trying my best, okay? I'll try and slot out more times. Get a better setup, all that jazz, and we can enjoy it more. So, thank you for coming. I'll try harder. You guys are the best. See ya.